We are all lathered up with sun cream. Morning everybody, it's day three of our holiday in Rhodes. And basically today we're just going to be sitting around on sunbeds. Aren't we, hon?
Yay!
Yeah, that's about it really. See you later. We think it's beer time, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Right then.
Yamas. Yamas.
Did you see that?
That seemed like a really good idea, didn't it?
God.
Oh,
what's all
God.
That about? At home, you just get nicked, wouldn't you? You're riding along with a pickup, with a bloke sitting on the tailgate, with a pushchair in the back and a baby in it. What are these Greeks thinking about?
Well, that's safe, isn't it?
Yeah, hilariously safe. It's like all the motorbike idiots go around with no helmets on, isn't it? Oh dear. Look at him on the phone. God.
That's alright.
Why is it alright?
He's on a bike.
So? He's still got to be in control, isn't he? Riding along on a bloody bike with a phone stuck to his ear. All that about? I wouldn't do it.
Yeah, but he's Greek.
How do you know that?
Well, we're in Greece.
Yeah, but everybody's here Greek. Huh? We're not Greek because we're here.
Yeah, but have you got your bike?
No, it's at home. They're all piled up in the garage.
So he must be Greek if he's got
no,
his bike
he's,
with him.
He's hired one, isn't he?
Oh, God.
Anyway, we're going to try out that
jacuzzi bar.
It's not really a jacuzzi, is it?
It's a jacuzzi bath. Jacuzzi, spa bath.
Spa bath. Sparkly bath. Anyway.
It's got things, jets.
Yeah.
Things.
We've got a jet thingy, bathy, what's it thing. So we're going to try that out now. Right, let's find out how to work this thing. Hang on. What's this? Hang on. There we go, look. Right. Cool. Hang on. I don't know what that thing's for. Most of that makes it frothier, does it? Oh, no, it turns it off. Hang on. What's going on here then? That's it then. Right. Shall we give it a go? Right, we'll see you in a bit. Well, that was a bit different. Bubbles, and I've just got the bubbles off my glasses because I haven't had my glasses on, so now to work a stupid thing because there's so much bubbles in there. I overdid the bubbles. They're all over the edge of the bath, all on the floor, all up the wall, so you couldn't see the bloody controls. Angie was laughing her head off and she's putting beards on me and hats on me and bubbles, but anyway. Right, so we're just having a little chill out now with a glass of wine before we go to dinner. So I think that's the end of the day, don't you, hon? We will see you on day four of our holiday tomorrow. Thanks for joining us today, guys. We'll see you later. Bye. Hello, everybody. I've been a bit lazy the last couple of days, mainly because I'm on holiday. And I've just been lazing around on sun loungers and going out to a couple of bars, and it's been very windy here as well, so it's not really vlogging sort of weather. But that's all we've been doing, we've just been lazing around. But I thought I would do my TV review. You remember back at Christmas when I did my TV review in Lanzarote with that horrible old grotty, Lanzarote TV, that old CRT. Well, I thought I'd show you this one because it is much better. It's more up to date, look. And you can actually see it's not as deep as the other one, obviously. But we still have the problem of no proper English channels. Okay, we don't want to sit here all day watching TV, but when you're getting ready to go out, it's nice to have the TV on in the background. Perhaps catch up with a bit of Corey or Emmerdale. I know some of you are going to say that's sad, but I think other things are sad, like watching football. So, but it's all our own opinion. But I have had a bit of criticism on my channel while I've been away about the Lanzarote TV. Why would you want to put a TV on in a foreign country? Exactly that reason. When you're getting ready for an hour, you know, you're just wandering about, it's nice to have it on the background. So I said to this person, oh, you've never had a TV on in a foreign country then? Oh yeah, when is football on? Say no more. And it was also about the grotty hairy bacon, but we won't go down that route. So we've had a look around the channels and we've got 14 German, we've got 9 Greek, we've got 1 French, we've got 5 Russian, 1 Belgian, 4 Italian, there is 7 English, but most of them American. It's all rolling news except for BBC News, which is the true English channel. So we've got no entertainment at all on these tellies, and most of the people in the hotel are English. So who are they catering for? Yeah, there's a few Germans here and a few this and the other, but they can all speak English, so if they put English channels on, we can all watch telly. So I think all these hotels just fall down in that respect. But saying that, this hotel is brilliant. The staff are fantastic. We've had a nice time. We've still got the bacon issue. But look, we've got the F1 on, but it's not. It's the break at the minute, but it's in German. So why can't they give it to us in English? You know, it'd be nice to see it in English rather than try and, you know, we can see what's going on, but it's nice to have a commentary in English. So that's it, really. That's the TV in a nutshell. I'm not going to go on about it. It's mainly rubbish. So there we go. So that's today. This is day 5 of our holiday. We missed out yesterday. We've done nothing today. We're going to go back into Rosetown tomorrow on the bus. And then that just leaves Sunday when we check out and come back home. So very short vlog today, just a TV review. Thanks for looking in, and hopefully I will see you tomorrow. Hello internet, YouTube world, and everybody everywhere. This is our last full day of our holiday, and as there's not a lot to do around the hotel, we're going back into Rhodes Town again to just spend a bit of time in. We can't, there's nothing else to do other than lay around. Yes? Sorry. Other than lay around on a sunbed all day. So there we go. So we got our tickets for the bus. It's ever so cheap here to get the bus in the town, so it's worth going. So we'll have a little look round at some other little parts of Rhodes Town, I think, didn't you?
We went up there yesterday, didn't we?
All up there yesterday. Yeah, that wasn't very interesting. That's why I didn't vlog it. We only went up there and had a coffee and walked all the way back again and sat laid on a little bed again, didn't we?
At least we got one.
At least it's holiday, that's what it's all about. Right.
Meant to be doing stuff.
Not meant to be doing stuff, just catching buses here, there and everywhere. Standing right at the front. we call Umbrella Street, because there's just loads of shops that sell umbrellas. I didn't think I'd see one of those. A €1 shop, that's the equivalent of a 79p shop at home, isn't it? That's not a pound shop, it's a 79p shop, it's cheaper. Right, see this fountain, which isn't really a fountain now, and all them spiky bits. See that bloke in the pink shirt there? We only came across to take a photo of that. The dandelion bit had a really nice effect, didn't it? Fountain effect. And as we picked our cameras up, he turned it off. I assume it's because we were going to eat in his poxy restaurant, but thanks for that, pal.
You know, you've just got that now, look.
How rude! Oh, look, we found a Costa. Oh, it's a bloody art place. What good's a bloody art place? And here we go, there's always a McDonald's. Look at this poor old thing, that's been there a little while, look. But I wouldn't mind that. Look at that, 500 a bath. Wow. And we've found an original little 500. You wouldn't believe that a bath that we just seen came from this little thing. Looks so tiny. And we're back in the square again. We are going to go for a pint.
Camara. The Wi-Fi is here.
Thank you very
much. E.
To them. Thank you very much.
Yamas.
Well, that was a nice liquid lunch, wasn't it, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. We went back to the bar that we went in on Tuesday. And they're very friendly, aren't they? And they gave us a free ouzo before we left. Very nice complimentary drink. Yeah, but they're really nice chaps. They're all struggling out here with business, aren't they? Mm.
But, shame.
Yeah, it's a very, yeah, a real shame. Yeah, so if we ever come back to Rhodes, we will go back to there.
Everest.
And if any of you guys come to Rhodes town, go to the Everest restaurant, bar, whatever you want to call it.
It's a grill.
It's a grill, that's it.
And it's in the little market square.
In the market square. You've got to go there because they're really nice chaps, really friendly. And yeah, so we're just sitting now at the harbour. We'll give a little bit of view of that in a minute, I expect. You've just seen the Poseidon Adventure going out. That'd be fun, wouldn't it?
Well, it says it's a submarine, doesn't it, on the side?
Well, I hope it's not a submarine, because they're all sitting on bloody top.
On the top, and it's called Poseidon, and the Poseidon sank in the film, didn't it?
Yeah.
So,
well, it'd be interesting.
Would you want to get on it?
It'd be interesting to see if it comes back, wouldn't it?
I think we've had a bit too much liquid for our lunch. Oh, yeah.
Strawberry cheesecake ice cream. Rude not to. Not bad for a euro.
Yeah, it's alright.
A bit soft though, isn't it?
Okay. Good.
Well, it looks like Poseidon Adventure has returned safely, hun.
Didn't sink up?
No.
Poseidon submarine.
We've just seen a pigeon land on a rock in the sea. Do you reckon they can swim?
Oh, they haven't got webbed claws.
Yeah, but what happens if they end up in the water?
Well, they just have to bob about a bit, wouldn't they? Because they haven't got flippers.
Fingers.
It'd be like something like that through the sea.
Yeah, would they not have buoyancy problems, or would they just bob up the wrong way?
Just
flip, because they've got no buoyancy down below. They're sort of top heavy, aren't they? just wonder what pigeon
you'd
have
to do, like you do in a canoe, you know, try and get yourself back up the
other. Yes.
Absolutely.
That's it then. That's the holiday then. That's all done, isn't it?
That's it then.